Hi everyone, today we're going to be talking about making screencasts using the app called Vittle. I'm going to use a series of screenshots to show you how I use this app with some of my classes. The first thing you'll want to do is to open up the App Store in order to download the app for Vittle. Once you've opened up the App Store, you can type in V-I-T-T-L-E in the search field and you'll have a series of options pop up. I'm currently using the full version of Vittle, this one right here, which costs about $8, but you can try it using the free version, which has almost all of the same features. Click this button and enter your password in order to download it onto your iPad. Once you've downloaded the app, click on this icon right here in order to open up Vittle. The home screen for the Vittle app will look like this. Mine obviously has a lot of screencasts on it because I use them all the time, but yours will be blank except for a tutorial. To start making your screencast, click this plus button in the upper left-hand corner. When you click the plus button, a new video will open up which is default titled My Vittle. And because I don't want to just call my video My Vittle, I'm going to change its name. So tap here on the title of the video in order to change it. When you tap the name of the video, a little menu will pop up with three options to rename, duplicate, or delete your video. We're going to hit Rename. I'm going to call this video Screencasting 101. Here's Vittle's work screen. It has a number of options up at the top to draw, erase, select, point, or add. And you can also choose the colors that you want to draw with by using these buttons right here. The first thing that I would like to do is to draw something on the screen, so I'm going to hit the Draw button right up here. When you tap the Draw button, you'll have two options to change the characteristics of your line. You can change its thickness, and you can change how opaque it is. Right now, the color that I have selected is this orange color, so the line will look something like this. If you want to do with some shading, you can also do something like this, where you add layers of color on top of each other in order to make it more or less opaque. If you don't want to use lines that are completely opaque, you can play around with shading and deposit layers of color like this. Also, if I decide that I don't like this orange color, all I have to do is tap the orange button up top. Tapping and holding the color that I don't want anymore will open up a color menu to select from a list of preset colors, or pretty much any color or shade in between. If I decide that I don't like something that I've now drawn, I have two options to change it. First, I could select the Erase button right here, and simply erase the last thing that I didn't like. And then if I change my mind, I can undo anything that I just did by tapping the Undo button right here. If I want to drag and drop or resize something on the screen, I can use the next button for the Select tool. This tool allows me to copy, paste, or move things around to different parts of my presentation. This tool allows me to move things between presentations or to copy and paste them to different parts of the same presentation. I use it pretty often if I don't like where things are placed on the page. If I decide that I want to add a photo to my presentation, I can click the Add button right here. This button allows you to open up the camera roll on your iPad. Now I can add any pictures that I have saved on here. Now let's talk about one of the most important things about screencasting, the recording portion. If you click this red button right here, it will start the recording process. You'll know if you're recording because you'll see a tiny counter going right here where the record button used to be. While you're recording, you can talk, draw, or do pretty much anything you want. When you're finished with a section of recording, you can either push pause or push stop. I like to record my screencasts in multiple small segments because I tend to make a lot of mistakes, so I usually will push stop instead of pause. The best way to understand the difference between stop and pause is to click the View button right here. Okay, so this is the View screen for Vittle, and this means that you can see that I've actually recorded this screencast in lots of little tiny segments because I tend to do a lot of misspeaks. This is probably the feature that I like the most about Vittle. I can delete or reorder chunks of this video anytime I want. To delete something, all I have to do is tap the scene that I don't like and swipe to the left. Then a delete button appears and I can delete the scene I don't want. This is especially handy if you misspeak or if you happen to be working, like I am now, in an area where there are lots of kids walking around and occasionally they make lots of loud noise. I couldn't get the entire screen to fit on here, so I want you guys to take a look down here at the very bottom, where you have the option to delete all of your scenes, or if you tap this button right here, to play what you've already recorded. The View menu is also really useful because you can use it to save your videos, so you can either opt to save it to your camera roll on your iPad, or you can tap Open In, and you can open it up in something like Dropbox if you want to send it out to your students or in an email. So now that we've gone through some basics of creating a screencast, here are some best practices for creating your own. So my number one tip is actually to have a set of notes prepared on the topic that you want to talk about so you know roughly the order you'll present your information and you make sure you don't forget anything. My second tip is to try to use a stylus. Even though the iPad is designed to use your finger, a stylus makes it significantly easier to do fine detailed work that you might need. Just like with planning a lesson, I also recommend that you limit your screencast to a couple of topics at a time. For instance, we recently did a project on respiration, but I didn't put everything about respiration into one screencast. Instead, I broke it up into several different ones to make it easier for the students to digest. And my fourth tip is to anticipate the length of the note-taking. So usually it takes students about 3 to 4 times as long to take notes as it does to actually watch the screencast. So a 5-minute screencast might take anywhere from 15 to 25 minutes for a kid to actually watch and take notes on. This final tip, number 5, is actually courtesy of my Bio 400 class, and they said that they really like it when I color coordinate between the screencasts and handouts that I give them. So for instance, every time I use ATP, which is a biological molecule, I always use the same symbol, and that's the same symbol that they see on their tests as well as on their handouts in class. Thanks for watching, everybody.